So that which can internally govern or stimulate an inner force, just as we are having the homeostasis inside our body, to develop the inner status of adaptability, assimilation, multiplicity and distributive value of the essential nutrients, which are governed on the basis of factors like temperature, altitude, sunlight, water and various other factors of the soil type, that which is internally governable so that it can adapt any system at any type on any ground. So certainly it proves that the growth of a plant, the sustenance of a plant, or the perfection or this nutrient precision of a plant is conditional. To make something to adapt any type of conditions by means of inducing the inner driving force, by means of going to the primordial factor of characteristic destination or determination known as genes, and by means of a transcription, retranscription and extirpation of the encoded message by means of a decoding, recoding and encoding process, the characteristic viability as well as compatibility that which already exists in the system is boosted, twisted or tuned. And this is known as artificial selection, and this type of selection is now growing in modern astrology. It started with the first hybrid era. It started with Gregor Mendel and Charles Darwin. Then it entered into heterosis, the theory of heterosis. Then the third era is M.M. Rhodes. He has made the cytoplasmic male sterility phenomenon, that is the CMS. That is the era of M.M. Rhodes. Then came the plant tissue, that is the plant tissue culture. The plant tissue culture means it has a narrow axis, narrower axis, wider axis. There are innumerable axis status for this crossing. In wider crossing, we can have even heterogenetic compositions, like triticate. We are having the triticate, the new hybrid cereal, which is a hybrid of wheat and rye. So like that, it comes in the era of the plant tissue culture. Then there is the era of chemical mutagens, like EMS, ethyl methane sulfonate, and dimethyl sulfate DMS, and radiators and transformers. These things are chemical mutagens. Then we are having the protoplast fusion and the latest chromosomal engineering. And the advent of molecular engineering, it has contributed a lot of things in molecular biology by means of, just now he has mentioned about markers. With a DNA fingerprint, we can induce millions of characters and differential behaviors of a system. Thousands of things we can incorporate at the same time. Simultaneous incorporation, effective incorporation, orderly presentation, systematic and precise value determination, infusion, fusion and mixture, everything is possible by means of this DNA fingerprinting. It is known as molecular marking. It is also ruling now. Now, there is a system of reverse breeding now. These people, they know better, and double haploids. The recent thing, and a very recent thing, the new bride of the development of plant genetics, that is genetic modification, in which a desired gene, a wished gene that is introduced inside by the removal of an RNAi, and the transcription is promoted by a promoter, as well as the termination sequence of stopping the transcription is also embedded inside simultaneously for the desired phenotype model. So it is there now, very much available for us. And now recently the rDNAs, that is the genetic recombination system, is coming. Now we are entering into pharmacrop era. That's what I delivered a lecture on pharmacrop. In pharmacology, I have selected the topic of pharmacrop, in which after 10 years, we did not take any medicine at all. First, we have been taking good food in good environment, and we had lesser opportunities to take medicines. Now, we have both medicines as well as food in equal status, qualitatively and quantitatively. Now, we are going towards such an era where we are consuming more medicines, both in quantity and quality. We are consuming more than the plants. Now, there is a pharma era. Certainly, I want India to develop a lot of things, because this gene mutation, gene coding, gene intrusion, fixation, these things can be universal. But identification of these things as per the Indian traditional herbal system by understanding various other potential herbs like Vitania somnifera, Osimum sanctimum, Osimum basilis, Avena sativa, they are all very powerful. And we have a strong record of herbaceum. We have a good materia medica. By understanding the principles of which we can produce pharmacrops. The pharmacrops naturally, they deal with a customized system to various other environmental repulsions, as well as behavioral repulsions, as well as etiological repulsions that naturally happens. For example, we can create such a crop which has more fiber content, which has more things that to do with anti-cancer, to anti-diabetic, anti-nephral, anti-neural, what are all the various problems that are persistently testing the society, to create an inbuilt, just as with they created induced pesticides in BT crops, like they developed BT corn, etc. In new emerging crops, they induced inbuilt pesticides. That is, they can create, the resistance mechanism has been induced and fermented in such a manner that they can create their own antigen to take care of the pathogens that are there in the environment or that attack their structure. Likewise, these pharmacrops is the very recent area where we have to ponder more, wherein by we need not require a triad. One is a food to live, and second is a medicine to take care of the disease, and third thing is a doctor, a multi-expensive system. Lot of trouble that we see, disease is not cruel. Diagnosis and treatment of the disease is more cruel than the disease itself. Lot of the treatments and diagnoses, people used to say that I am happy with, are you clapping by your experience or something? No, most of the area, no, I have heard the patient saying that taking these medicines or taking this treatment or diagnosis is cruel than the disease, I am better with the disease itself. So we can avoid various other unwanted intrusions, except some unavoidable these things, we can escape from most of the things. So for natural survival, we need food. That is dharana, poshana and bhogya. Dharana is that governs your salubrity. Poshana is that governs your metabolism. Bhogya is that gives you taste. So we get everything by means of these pharmacrops. It is just a very great bheshaja. It is also an aushadha. It is also a virudha, what I have told now. So we can get biological support for metabolic activities. We can get survival mechanism, and we can get also the medical substitution which we are getting from so many unreliable and pernicious sources, we can get from standard and stable sources. So this is the greatness of pharmacrops, and certainly I believe that one day we are going to organize a seminar on pharmacrops. Certainly pharmacrops, that is going to be the emerging era. Then just as he has quoted about various pattern issues, whenever you develop in the advent of science, you simultaneously used to face problems. They are unavoidable. Number one, it is cross-expectational or cross-desirous behavioral change in the expected elements. It is either expected change or expectation change or behavioral change. Whatever we think that we are genetically modifying, that it is productive, that it is behavioral as per the expectation, that sometimes misbehaves. So there is no surety. Even now, most of the people in gene mutation, especially even in nanotechnology, the behavior of the nanoparticles in the digital drug drive, as well as morbid region drug delivery systems and digital drug delivery systems, they are told that now we are feeling and finding safe. We cannot assure how far we have reached inside this genetic process and nano drug process. Both in biogenetics they have assured. So now whatever we have done, because now there was a very great rebellion that has been caused by this BT Brinjal. Lot of people, they protested against it recently, it happened everywhere. Like most of the people, like BT cotton, lot of the farmers, they cultivated lot of such products. So farmers' expectation, scientist expectation, social greed or wider expectation, that has been nullified by the product. Because whatever that has been injected, that becomes nullified, number one. That does not behave at all. Number two, that behaves, but only to a particular time. It is ephemeral, it does not behave so. That is not deeply incorporated in the continual or peripheral or consecutive cycles of the productivity level of that particular gene. If it is there in the product X, then in the various productive consecutive level of the cyclic generation, the behavior is not repeated. It has four types of different behaviors.